back. So, as last time, I created a Kanban board. I started adding my different tasks. And the first one we're going to do is initial plumbing right here, which is just a basic setting up GitHub and everything that I want to do in order to get started with the next step right here and to actually start building the code. It's always a good idea to start by making branches for the feature you're going to change right here instead of just messing up the main branch or anything like that. So initial plumbing, that's the first one we want to do. Let's just get this started. I'll jump in and just start Pomodoro. And there we go. Now it's starting to count down. I have 15 minutes. Let's get going. So let's jump into Writer right here and just get started. The first thing I want to do right now, I'm on the main branch. So always start with a pull request. That's the first thing you do just to make sure that you got all the code from the current branch in the cloud. So there we go. Now we have a pull request, meaning that I'm on the newest code on my main branch right here. Happy days. Then I'll do a checkout because I want to make a new branch right here. So I'll do a git checkout, and the new branch that I want to build is going to be called security. So I'll do a checkout minus B to explain I want to build a new branch from the current branch I'm in. And there what I want to do is just call it security. That's just going to be the name of my branch, and we'll just execute that and we switch to a new branch called security. Now this branch has everything the main branch has now. So whatever's in the main branch is now in this security branch. The final thing you can do is you can just actually push this to the cloud so you guys can access it. So I'll do a git push. I'll say I want to go to the origin. That's the main branch in the cloud, or sorry, that's the main git repository I'm using in the cloud. And there I want to push this new security branch that I just built right here. If I could spell security. And there we go. Now we have the branch in the cloud, so you guys can actually go for that individual branch right there. And later, of course, we'll merge that using a pull request back into the code in the cloud. So that was just setting up the backend branch, and we are now ready to use that one. I also want to do the same for the frontend branch, so let's jump into Angular. In Angular, let's just do a git branch right here, just to see what branch I'm actually on right now. There we go, we're on the main branch. We also have the git all in the basic branch. And now since I'm on the main branch, again, the first thing I do is just a git pull. I just want to be sure I have the newest data locally, so git pull is the way to do that. When that is done, I'm going to do a git checkout again, and I'm going to make a new branch again, and minus B, and then I want the new security branch here for the frontend code as well. So we have these separate completely. And the final thing is just to push it back. So I'll do a git push, origin, and security. Now you don't need to put it back if you don't want to, because if you're only working this on your own, you don't need to put it onto GitHub. But always, it's nice to have it on GitHub. If something goes horribly wrong, the code is available up there later on. So now we're on the new security branch, and everything we change from now on is only going to be on this branch, so we can mess anything up if we want to. It's not going to destroy our production setup or anything like that. And every time you want to change, you just do a git checkout and go to whatever branch you want to go to. Like this is the get all branch that we used earlier. Swing, I jump to that one, and you'll notice now things change over here, because now I have all this code that's actually available for the get all branch. Now in this case, they're actually the same because the get all has just been merged into the main branch, but this is how you kind of do these changes. So I'll go back to my actually security branch right here, and now we're good to go. Now we've cleaned up everything and we can start working with our own branches right here, and we won't mess up anybody else's branches in our system. So let's clear everything out and just get ready to actually do some code in the next lesson. So see you next time. Bye-bye.